And I suppose that I ought to be sharing this on my other computer. So hi, Julia.
Hi, how are you doing?
I think we are live. Would you like to confirm that by looking?
Yeah, I can go and check right now, actually.
Okay.
Yes, we are definitely live and I can share it on Facebook.
Okay, good. I'll try to share it on Twitter. Okay. So we're just going to talk about the news of the day, which can mean anything that happened today that was of interest to us.
Sure, it sounds good to me. Just sharing it in a couple spots.
Okay, good. You know what? What I think we could do if we know how to screen share is we could share some of our memes, you know, that we are currently sharing with other people.
Yeah, we could definitely do that for sure. Trying to get it to share on the right spot. We should do that. I just didn't know how you wanted to approach that since you have created them. I was going to leave that up to you, but we can definitely share them.
Yeah, we can share them. So I've been painting and I've been trying to get my paintings to have significance for other people, you know, and obviously you could say, well, look at the painting, you know, a picture is worth 1,000 words, but sometimes if you add a couple of words, it's worth even more.
Yeah, it can convey a bigger message, a stronger message, theme, what have you. Definitely. I know that you like to convey things like through your work.
Yes. Yes, I do. Yeah. I like for my work to at least share some ideas with other people. Let's put it that way.
I like that you do that, and I admire that because I think we don't see a lot of that. Well, we see some of it, but just lately I don't feel like there's a lot of original thought put out there. I hear a lot of the same things all the time, and I actually watched something that was about that, where there was a scientist with a virus epidemiology background who worked on vaccines, and I thought it was really interesting, the documentary I watched, but I guess I'll leave it at
that. Yeah, I saw that too, I did. We're not going to name the documentary, but here's the thing, you know, and people talk about conspiracy theories and whether we should believe in them or not. So what I would like to say about that, and that's something that I've been called on lately, you know, people say, you know, you're very intelligent, but you seem to believe in a lot of conspiracy theories. You know, that's a way of putting me down. Always with, first of all, oh, you're very intelligent, but then, okay.
Yeah, it's kind of rude, really. Like, there's no need. Just because they don't want to look deeper into issues doesn't mean there isn't something to those issues.
Right, but here's the thing. Sometimes conspiracies exist, and sometimes they don't. And so the question isn't, is this a conspiracy theory? The question is this theory correct or incorrect? Is there any convincing evidence for it? But for instance, at the time when my grandparents and my father, who was 4 years old, left Poland that was being occupied on one side by Russia and on the other side by Nazi Germany, when they left, and they left by stealth, you know, people tried to convince my grandmother that she and my father was 4 years old, should stay behind, because even though the Nazis might be cruel or bad or whatever, and might be conquerors, they would never hurt women and children, because after all, they were German, and Germans are nice people. and they knew Germans. But my grandmother had an encounter with someone, a German who told her, run, you know, don't go into this office. Don't report to register yourself.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So she knew that there was something going on. And yeah, it was kind of a conspiracy because the Nazis didn't go around telling everyone we're going to kill
women. Person must have had some integrity to tell her that and to try and help you.
Right. Which is, yeah, again, this is not something against Germans. This is against the Nazi regime. And the same way when we talk about China and what they did, you know, communist China.
Yeah,
we're not against Chinese people.
No, because there were a lot of people that spoke out about what was happening early on and things happened to them.
And yet, right. And even when we talk about the federal government, we know there are good people who happen to work for the federal government. So it's not as if every government employee is necessarily a bad person, but some of them are.
The doctor actually worked for an agency of the federal government, but she came across the certain issues that they discussed in the documentary that, oh, I found a cure for something, but it was delayed and people maybe could have been saved. It's very interesting.
They delayed her publication and then they stole her research. And they patented it and made money on it. And then they arrested her and they put a gag order on her. And this gag order stuff really does happen.
Yeah.
A lot of people who not only does the law, you know, do them wrong, but for a very long time, they're not allowed to talk about what was done to them.
Wow. It's interesting that documentary disappeared. Why would it disappear if it weren't true?
Well, okay, let's not go that far because you know what? It could have been false. Okay, look, you know, when you know, everything could be false. I don't know the truth. I wasn't there.
I know you weren't there, and I'm not saying, but
okay, so it could disappear for a number of reasons. It could disappear because YouTube or somebody was afraid that a lawsuit for defamation of character would be brought against them, and they didn't want that to happen. Mm-hmm. There are lots of reasons why something might be taken down, and I'm not saying that just because it was taken down, it's necessarily the truth. There are a lot of things that are taken down that are totally
I'm not saying it's 100% the truth, but it seems pretty odd, just the circumstances given.
Yeah, no, I'm not saying it's not 100% the truth. I'm saying the fact that it was taken down isn't proof that it's the truth or not the truth. It just, we don't know. But it sort of, it sounded like something that I'd already heard had happened to somebody else.
And a lot of the things that they were saying were things that doctors are coming out and saying on YouTube, doctors that have experience with certain virus, like their experience, like they use clips. So I'm not saying it's 100% true, but I'm kind of erring on leaning towards thinking they're more accurate than some people would like us to believe. That's kind of my interpretation of it.
Yeah. And it smells like the truth to me. You know, I don't know whether it's the truth, but it seems rather truthful. But then the question is, we have friends who are absolutely certain that those things are conspiracy theories and are not true. And the question is, how does one go about figuring that out? And how does one talk to one's friends?
I can easily say, in the past, we always questioned, like, when information came out of China. We especially under the Communist Party, that has never had any compunction, like the Great Leap Forward, many people died. Do we believe the numbers that they put out? And I'm sorry if that offends anybody. The Communist Party isn't exactly the most truthful entity on the planet. Not that any government is, but they have a vested interest in covering up the truth and putting out really good PR. I don't know. But I'm not saying our government's completely, or any other government, is completely absolved in this one, because it seems like...
Well, I mean, this was not about China. This was about... I mean, it was not primarily about China.
Well, it's not even about China per se, but there is a lab. It was funded. There were some research funded by our government. There were projects that the Chinese government knew about, and it seems that there are mainstream news articles that have talked about how, yes, maybe it wasn't purposeful, maybe it wasn't intentional, but there were animals taken to this lab, and they somehow, that's how the virus got out.
Right.
And I think there's truth in that. And that's not really a conspiracy theory. There were mainstream news articles.
Okay. It is. Okay. Let me tell you why that. Okay. First of all, a conspiracy is not necessarily true or a false thing. So the idea that something is a conspiracy theory, right now we are being smeared every time we have a conspiracy theory. What I'm telling you, my grandmother, she had a conspiracy theory about the Nazis. It really was a conspiracy theory, but it was also true.
Yeah.
Okay. Here's the thing. In that documentary that we saw, a gentleman who was in charge of all of these American efforts to fight the coronavirus, this person, who I'm not going to name, but you've seen him.
Oh, yes.
On television, in the news, this person is implicated. So it's not just about China.
No, it's not. It's definitely about our government too. And they funded things that happened in that lab.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's on both sides, and many governments are probably involved in different issues of this nature. I'm not saying it's all China or all the US, but I think that the elites have a vested interest in not being fully disclosing things that have happened. That's just my take on it.
Yes. But the question is why?
Why?
Yeah.
Well, when you have a person that has billions of dollars and they don't have, and this is what I thought before she said it, and thank God she said it, because now I feel like, okay, we have somebody with a science background that finally said it. A person that has billions of dollars who doesn't have a medical background, why does everybody praise him for being so, like, pro? She's not anti-vaccine, by the way. She says she's pro-immigrant.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah. Yes.
But she doesn't like the idea of just backing any kind of vaccine, especially when it could kill people. And we know
this. You know what? That's actually how I feel, too. I'm not anti-vaccine either. Recently in conversations, when I said it shouldn't be mandatory, then I got labeled an anti-vaxxer.
And that's what I hate. It's like, okay, we have both had vaccines, but I don't like the idea of just getting any kind of vaccine. And even my sister, like when her kids were in high school, there was a long list of vaccines that they were told that they had to have that we never had to have, that she was like, why? Like all of a sudden, all these teenagers had to have extra vaccines beyond basic ones that So I think you should have some latitude in what decision-making for your own person and not have to take a mandatory vaccine, but that's just my take on it.
Well, I mean, that's also a control mechanism on the quality of the vaccine. If people get to choose what they take into their bodies or don't take into their bodies, that's a way to make the vaccine manufacturers also accountable. And they, of course, should not have immunity from prosecution in case they make a terrible mistake and hurt somebody. Mm-hmm. But if we have all of those things in place, then every family or every individual can choose which vaccines are best for them.
Right now, the thing is, though, and I hate to go on and on about this, is some people are saying, well, that person's a good person because they wear a mask. or they get a vaccine. But those people are bad people because they chose their individual right not to ingest a certain vaccine into it.
Well, I don't know. Did you see the articles about the little two boys in China who died while taking a PE test? You know, they were exercising and they were trying to run or whatever they were being tested on their physical abilities, but forced to wear a mask while they were doing it. And they just dropped dead.
Not surprised. You know what they don't talk about with the mask? And I can freely say it 100%. You wear a mask for 40 hours a week, it can make you feel, I have a high heat tolerance. But if somebody's an average person and they're wearing a mask, I'm surprised more people haven't passed out. Anytime you go to a store and you talk to somebody, my own sister said, it gives you a headache. And 2 days in, you're getting a headache. So why is it that all these people that are so pro-masks not acknowledge that maybe there's some side effects, like the story, that bad things can happen from having to wear that mask?
And see, what I heard is that after this happened, it didn't happen on the same day. It happened to one boy on one day and then happened to another boy on another day. After this happened, the people in that province decided to no longer have any physical exams for their PE class. They didn't decide not to wear masks. They just said, okay, exams are canceled.
Okay.
Yeah.
We never thought of the mask. But, you know, oh, and that's another thing too, okay? The Honeyville plant mask video that I told you about, it was pretty ridiculous. You know why? Did I tell you about that? I know you didn't see it.
Oh, you said something about the music playing in the background.
Yeah, they were saying that Trump picked like a Guns N' Roses song about death, but it wasn't him. It was music they were playing at the plant. Mm-hmm. And they said he was playing that music and that he had some sinister like plan behind it. And I'm not even a Trump fan. I honestly don't even listen to the guy because honestly, I don't get it. Like the people who hate him the most seem to know more about him than I ever will because they spend their whole living flip-flop day. Like, I don't know. Well, for example, here's the thing. Somebody said they made a Trump baby balloon in England. And I'm like, why? Why would anybody do that? Why would anybody who claims to hate somebody like spend all their energy and time making a float mocking them? I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't know. I try to spend my energy making things that will have an impact on the way people think about.
Mm-hmm. No, I know you do.
Yeah, so I would never make it a float like that.
No, you wouldn't, but I'm beginning to think this is why, like, you can make a really intelligent, smart, thoughtful meme. But the type of thing that seems to resonate with people right now is something like that. I don't get it, but that seems to, it's weird, but I don't know. That seems to be what people are talking about. Like somebody told me about that. I'm like, why would I care? I'm just sharing because I don't care about their float, but that's what they told me about. But we could share your meme. Would you like to share? Would you like me to share the memes on the meme page so people
could
see
it? Before we do that, do you want me to just show you the two paintings, the one of the fat lady and the one of the beautiful girl?
Yeah.
And we can show that.
Okay. We can have you do it too if you prefer. Well, so we started a libertarian meme page back in early April. But Aya has created most of the memes because I don't really create memes. I mean, I did once for a cat, but I'm not much of a meme creator.
Okay, so this is my fat lady painting. And remember how you said that even though the painting is kind of nice, maybe people are not attract, you know, don't like the meme because she's not an attractive woman, right?
Yeah, I just wondered, like, you know, discrimination, like people say that they don't discriminate against heavy set people, but I kind of get that vibe that they do to some degree.
Yeah, so my next painting was
a very beautiful, like she has like a 1960s vibe, very beautiful, sultry woman.
Right. So I thought, well, okay, let's do something with a beautiful woman. But that didn't work either for people so far.
I don't know. Like, to me, like, they're both great paintings, but I feel like if a meme is too thought out, maybe people just, I don't even get why certain things are popular, to be honest with you. I'm the wrong person to ask. I don't know.
Okay, well, anyway, let's go ahead and share the meme page.
Okay, I'll go ahead and do that.
Because, you know, it seems to me that there's a lot of jealousy, there's a lot of envy, and the bad guys are using these bad feelings that people have toward their neighbors to fuel a lot of bad things that are happening.
Yeah, that's something too, but they say that they're the kind people. They're like, we are kind, those people are bad. But it doesn't feel that way. I don't feel like people who like say you should hate your neighbor if they're not wearing a mask or they stand too close or they go to the beach, that doesn't make me think that they're nicer people. I actually feel the opposite when I hear them say those things. Why do I feel the opposite? Am I the only one that thinks this way? I don't think so.
No, I don't think so either.
You want to know what it is? Is that people don't want to be bullied, so they're just not going to tell you their opinion on Facebook. But I see plenty of people that go outside without a mask on. People are not going to stay inside. Like, people should if they want to. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with staying home, but you can't force everybody to stay home for the rest of their life. Like, there's literally people right now saying, if you leave the house, that you're a bad person.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
That's ridiculous. But, like, it kind of, like, I think there's a lot of people, they probably, let me share the page. If they didn't know any better, they'd probably be scared. They'd probably be like, well, I can't say anything because I'm a bad person if I think differently. I don't know. So can you see it now, Aya?
No, I can't. I see.
Hold on 1 second. I didn't hit share yet. Okay, share. Okay. Why is it not working? It was working the other day. Let me try again. It's just being wonky. Okay. Sorry about that, guys.
So there's also this thing about whether you are or are not a scientist. A lot of times people will say, oh, really? Are you a scientist? And of course, it's questionable whether I am or am not a scientist. I do consider myself a primatologist because I work with a chimpanzee, but I'm not a biologist. I'm not a medical expert. And so when I talk about these things that we're talking about right now, I'm just a lay person like anybody else.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean I'm not allowed to think or to calculate 1 + 1 = 2.
Of course not. Like, you have, like, you studied science. It's part of linguistics to some degree, I would imagine, right?
Well, some people think so, yes.
Can you see it now, by the way?
Okay, I'll tell you what, maybe it needs me to okay that. I do see it down there now. Okay, so now I okayed it.
Okay. So this is the libertarian meme page, and we need to add more to it. So far... that's what's visible on the page, but more memes will be added.
Okay, well, I shared the memes there. Can you see the shared memes and make them visible?
I can go ahead and make them visible. I just will have to play around with it. So maybe I should go out of, let me see. Because I think I'm gonna have to play around with the page a bit more. It seems like it's not showing. They're just not showing up for some reason.
Okay.
Maybe we can do your Facebook, Instagram, because I think you posted them on Instagram too, right?
Yes, I did. I did yesterday. I think I posted at least 2 memes and some others before that.
Yeah, because I need to play around with that page, and I'm sorry that I just haven't played around with things enough. To be honest with you, that's part of, I'm out of screen share, right?
You're out of screen share. So do you want to go to my Instagram maybe and look at some of this?
Yeah, that's where I was going to head on over now.
Meanwhile, I could just save.
Okay. So let's see. Oh, I like that. Where you can see side by side, they're like the same. That's pretty neat.
Yeah.
You know, even though one is like the beautiful woman and one's considered the heavier set, uglier woman, they could be a mother and daughter in a way.
Yeah.
Because they have like similar. I was just kind of thinking that too. So it kind of shows, but that's pretty neat. Like the size, 8 by 11, right?
Yeah, I think it's 8 by 10.
Oh, 8 by 10. Very cool. Okay, so do you want me to share the Instagram memes or?
Yes, please.
Can you see it now, Aya?
No, not yet.
Okay, you have to approve it, I think.
Yeah, I know, but I don't see it yet. I can only approve it after I see it.
Okay, let me see if I hit share. Hold on.
See, when it shows up, it's like another screen at the bottom, and then I do have to approve it before it becomes.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. Okay, share screen. Okay. Do you see?
I only see you and me at the bottom, you know, and what happens is when you first came in, you were at the bottom. And I approved you. Oh, now I see it. I see it now.
Okay.
So I'm going to approve it.
I'm having a hard time doing it in a shared one. It seemed like it was easier.
Well, Zoom might have been easier, but something went wrong with Zoom.
Well, even when I did it with by myself, it just was a little bit. But I think because you have to approve it. So here's this one. The emperor is not wearing a mask. How do you tell? How can you tell? Are you a scientist?
Yeah. Right.
Funny. By the way, our governor doesn't wear a mask either. Like in all of those talks, I would like to see him give one of his speeches wearing a mask. Like, why doesn't he wear one? He wants everybody else to wear one, but why isn't he wearing one when he gives a speech? Because we have to talk on the phone with a mask on. I think he should too. Like, practice what you preach, you know?
Sure. I mean, I actually had a picture of the federal officials, including the president, all of them not wearing a mask and not social distancing. But I
Zach, did you put this one on here so I could see it? Or is that on Vacuum County?
It might have been on Vacuum County. I kind of go between the two.
Let me go look and see. Because that one was actually really good, I thought.
Yeah, I thought.
It is. Okay, do you see it now, Aya?
Yes, there it is.
So some of these people are social distancing, or none of them are wearing masks, and these two are pretty close, and they're obviously farther away from Trump, and the people in the audience are sitting apart, but.
Right, so some of these people are not social distancing or wearing masks. I'm calling the cops. And a lot of times when I posted that, I would say, does anybody know a number to call to complain about this? You know, because they're having people, rat out their neighbors. But can we do that with these people?
It's so ridiculous. You know what, right now? Okay. Even here in California, some counties are loosening shelter in place. Like they're like, they finally decided, well, they're gonna let people go to the beach this weekend, or they go to the park. Like they're not gonna close the dog parks anymore or something. And there's people that are mad about that. And I've always been of the thought, well, if you were so worried and you didn't want to go out and you felt that it was safest for yourself not to go out, then you're not going out, right?
Right.
So how do you not going out get impacted by people that are going out all the time? I just don't. It doesn't add up to me. It's kind of like, okay, you don't like to drink, so you're not going to go to the bar, but you're upset that everybody's going to the bar to drink, and they might get drunk, but I don't. it doesn't add up to me. They keep saying that these people going out are going to somehow make them sick when they're staying home.
Well, it's the same thing with vaccines. It's one thing if you tell people, listen, the vaccine could help you not get sick. That I can understand. And then you can decide, I want the vaccine or I don't. I want to take the risks that are involved in order to avoid the other risks. But now they're telling people, you have to take the vaccine in order to save other people, not to save yourself from the disease, but to save other people. Which begs the question, if the vaccine is so good, why do you need me to take it? Why don't you take it yourself?
It's, you know, that's the thing. It doesn't make any sense, and I've never agreed with that. It started with the flu shot. Like, I would always hear people say that about the flu shot. But then there were a lot of people here in California that didn't want their children to get vaccines, even if they attended, like, a public school. But then in January, they overturned that law and said that you would absolutely, positively, even if you want to go to the public school, have to have a vaccine now, like have to have all your vaccines that in the past you couldn't have exemption from. And I don't know why all of a sudden that was the case. When if your children have the vaccine, but they keep saying these people are going to compromise everybody else because they don't have it, they might get it. But if you believe in the vaccine and you get it, won't that give you that? But then again, you can't have this conversation, but the scientists did in the documentary. They said that they weren't anti-vaccine, but they didn't seem like they wanted to push it on people either. But I could be wrong. Like, I don't know. Did you get, I mean.
Yeah. She's for good vaccines, but she said that there's something wrong with the vaccines that they're pushing right now. And she didn't really talk about the agenda, but do you want to show a few more of the memes or?
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry to go. Okay. If after all this, we still have, what if after all this, we still have to wear masks? That's another question too, because a lot of people are now saying, well, this is going to be the new normal and wearing a mask is such a good thing. But it's kind of sad because, like, are we just never supposed to see people's faces again? And then for all the people who say, well, it's so selfless and you're helping somebody else, what about deaf people who can't hear and they read lips? Like, when somebody says that, I just think that they're wrong because you basically just said, well, you're going to help everybody who feels uncomfortable with you not wearing a mask. And that makes me feel good. But it doesn't matter how you feel about it. It doesn't matter if you, like, I think it's wrong to make people have to wear a mask. You can't justify that at all to me. And if you try, I don't think that it's American. I think it's un-American when you say that everybody has to wear a mask. I don't care what you think about that. Because we should have some sort of freedom in this country to decide for ourselves if we wear a mask. I mean, if a store says that we have to, I don't entirely agree with it, or certain places say that we have to inside, but outside, that's ridiculous. I don't think people should have to wear masks when it's 120 degrees outside walking. But I guess if you drive and you have the luxury of driving, then you can be a snob and judge me for walking, because that's really what it's about. I feel that all the people that pretend to be kind-hearted, they're not.
Yeah.
But nobody has to agree with my view. That's just my take on it. But I like this. I think it's, I'm sorry, I went out. Why should we have to wear masks? Who is it for?
Well, the thing that got me was I'm in a group of people who are talking about, you know, just how to live with the current situation. And most of those people are liberals, I'll just tell you. And I don't go in there to start a fight because I'm there to hear what's going on. I'm there to get information. Sometimes I will share information, but I'm not there to fight.
Yeah.
But one of the ladies organizing the group said, oh, it's great that we have these masks now, because even after we go back to normal and we're not afraid of this particular virus, it will be nice to have that for flu season. And everybody can wear their masks for flu season. Well, flu season happens every year.
I've never worn a mask. Nobody's ever worn a mask. 2 months ago, people thought that was excessive. you know, if some cultures are okay with wearing a mask and they consider that courtesy, that's fine. Culturally, that's what they do. But let's go deeper than that. Let's go a little bit deeper. It was also considered courtesy. It was also considered good things to do foot binding and genital mutilation in some cultures. So maybe we shouldn't say because a culture considers something courtesy that that's a good thing to do, because maybe not everything in a culture that's considered courtesy. Like, this may seem benign, Aya. This is a more benign thing, but what's the implication of requiring everybody to wear a mask?
Well, that you don't get to decide what you do or do not wear. And so then I'm in this mockery group. Again, yeah. I don't always agree with the mockery people, but I try to sell my memes rather than go with their mockery. But yeah. What their mockery is basically to set up, you know, say, look at all these anti-science people and let's laugh at them. So let's laugh at the flat earthers, or let's laugh at the people who think that 5G is what causes the virus. You know, all sorts of really laughable theories that some people have.
But, you know, I don't think anybody thought that 5G caused the virus. I think some people were just kind of concerned that it was interesting that the 5G was being created in the same region where the virus was also maybe created in a lab. That was kind of what I heard. It was a little bit more complex. I think people simplified it. I think they were just saying, why are all these things happening in this particular region?
Okay. Anyway, they made memes about how silly some people's ideas are and how silly their conspiracy theories are and how unscientific these people are. And then they start to make it seem like you have to be a scientist to be able to think for yourself at all.
But do you know who's not a scientist that promotes vaccines worldwide? People like somebody who's not a scientist that has billions of dollars is very pro-vaccine, but he doesn't have a science degree, or he doesn't have a science background, but it's okay for him to, I don't know, because he's famous?
Yeah, or rich, or whatever. Yeah.
Or he's, I don't know, part of the in-crowd? Like, I'm not, like, look, I've never considered myself what you would call a conspiracy theorist, but I like to think. I don't want to just accept something because they said it on MSNBC. I don't want to just say, like, oh, that's what MSNBC told me to feel today, or somebody said these people are bad, I better hate them now. Like, I just think that's so negative. But anyway, I think this is a great meme. I really hope that we don't have to still wear a mask for the rest of our lives. That would be sad.
Yeah. So I shared a few others. Let's see if you
can. Okay, I'll go to the next one. It's the painting, I think, again.
Let's see.
Or maybe I'm on back and carrying them on. I'm sorry. Back to the other one.
Okay. Okay, yeah, there's some here. So,
did this one yet?
Yeah, this one is good. So that there are some people who say, not only do we have to listen to scientists and medical experts, but we should only listen to the ones who say what the government wants us to listen to. So if there's a medical doctor working in the field and he has a different opinion, we shouldn't listen to him. If there is a researcher who is a scientist, but he doesn't have the standard opinion of most scientists, we shouldn't listen to him. So my point is, science is not a popularity contest. It's not majority rule. When 4 out of 5 scientists agree, number 5 could be right.
Number 5 might have actually done more like evidence-based research in that field, and the other scientists might not know as much as number 5. I mean, what? It's not a popularity contest. You're absolutely right. It's too bad that people view it that way.
So most of the people in that group are actually very authoritarian in their view of science.
Wow. I always thought science was this great thing where we could learn more about the world and learn more about infectious disease or DNA. I never knew that science was like where people that were sitting at home on Facebook were all of a sudden like working in labs. Okay, that's quite a jump, but
yeah,
they're scientists now.
No, they're just the science police. They'll say, no, I'm not a scientist, so I'm not thinking for myself. How dare you think for yourself if you're not a scientist?
You should think for yourself, and you should read information. Even good doctors will be like, well, don't take my word for it. Get a second opinion. Do your research. A good doctor would tell you that.
Yep.
I don't know, but hey, that's interesting. Should I go to the next one?
Yes, if you can find one that's a meme.
Let's see. Shelter in place, you can never get the virus because ticks can't travel.
Okay, so you can get a virus just by touching a surface. It's not the ticks transmit necessarily this virus, but they can mechanically move stuff around from one place to another, from one person and to another, including those things that if you touch them, you could get the virus. Mm-hmm. We are now in tick season. We are also in fly season. Flies do mechanically spread a lot of stuff that can cause disease. People have known that for a long time.
Yeah, no, that's common sense. I mean, yeah, definitely it's common sense.
And in fact, Governor Cuomo recently announced that 2/3 of the people right now in New York who are coming down with the virus are not people who have left their house. They're not people who have not social distance. They're people who stayed at home, did as they were told, and came down with the virus.
See, that's what I knew was going to happen. Like I said, that I have a feeling in big cities that or even in more rural, I had a feeling that would happen. Interesting. So it did happen, because to me, like, it didn't make any sense that you just stay home. I don't know. Like, I mean, I guess like you don't want to go, like, here's the thing. I never went to like baseball gatherings. I never went to big parties, but I didn't think like staying home would necessarily make you safer. If anything, like those doctors were saying in the documentary, it's going to diminish your immunity to many other things once people start going out again. Like, if you're not immunodeficient, I think that they're giving people really, like, I'm sorry, but how long are we supposed to stay home?
I have no idea. I have no idea. And I'm not saying that I have the answer. I'm just saying that every time I see something that doesn't make sense, I'm not afraid to point it out.
No, and you shouldn't be. And I'm glad that you don't. That's good.
Yeah. So, yeah, I think that might be all of the memes that I have. Okay. Right.
I'll stop sharing at the moment. But okay. Maybe I'm too much of like the rebel in this one, because like I got a lot of hate early on. Well, you know what somebody told me? Why are you walking around by yourself?
Well, they used to tell me that even way before there was ever an epidemic or a pandemic or whatever it is. I used to go walking in my neighborhood when I was a teenager, just walking by myself. And people would stop and say, well, why are you walking? Do you need a ride? You know, it was just weird.
Yeah, it was weird. Like, walking's a bad thing. Like, it's bad to get out and exercise or something. Or even if you just don't drive and you walk, like, oh no, like, it's just strange. But then, like, right now, like, people would be like, oh my gosh, like, why are you walking by yourself? Well, okay, thanks. Like, I don't drive. I don't know what to tell you. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. But it's interesting that all the people that were like pro public transportation are now like anti public transportation, anti national park, anti everything that they used to be pro.
Yeah. Yeah. It is pretty amazing. I think if we do have public areas, they should be open at all times. I think if we want to tell people not to go out, the police should be the first people we should tell that to.
Yeah, and they were actually doing that. Like, they were going all around in LA making sure that non-essential, like, shops, like barbershops, weren't operating. Okay. So they were out walking around doing the thing that, like you said, if we had all stayed home for 2 weeks, like Nassim Taleb said, but nobody would have went out. Nobody. But
right.
That's never going to happen. So at this point, it's been about 2 months now. They really started I think it's places are going to open up eventually, and there's nothing people can do about it.
Absolutely. I think it is already opening up. Even in states where people are not allowed to leave home, they're starting to leave home because, you know what? You can only keep people at home for so long.
I've seen it because I worked, and I would walk home. In the first 2 weeks, like even before we went into official shelter in place, it was like deadly quiet. And we were like, oh, somebody told me they went to a movie and there was nobody there. And then I happened to go to Del Taco. I hadn't been in a long time. And there was nobody there. It was very creepy. It was very eerie. And it was just very quiet. But then after a few weeks, people started coming out again. And now, like, it's pretty much as it used to be. People just aren't working, but they're going other places. Like, I don't think people are going to stay home forever. But you can stay home if you want to. Like, I don't have to go out all the time, but if people want to, they don't have to go out.
Yeah. No, here's the thing. People used to think that I was a shut-in, you know, because I stayed mostly at home. Of course, I would always go for walks on my property.
Yeah, that's nice.
But because I have to take care of Bo, I couldn't go away. You know, I couldn't go elsewhere.
Mm-hmm. That's so fine.
Yeah, so I still don't, you know, it's not like I go out and socialize, and I'm a social butterfly. Most of the time I meet with no one. But yeah, you do have to leave the house sometime.
Yeah, sometime you have to, unless, I don't know, like, some people think you could just stay home indefinitely. Look, I'm just gonna let the people say whatever they want to say. I haven't been following this issue as much lately because it's like the same thing all the time and they don't have any answer for you. And basically, like, there would be shortages if everybody stopped working. I think people know that, right?
Yeah, we're concerned about food shortages, meat shortages, potato shortages, egg shortages, all of that. And you know, that's why I have my ducklings and my chicks.
No, it's smart that you did that, but a lot of the people that were upset about food shortages were also upset that some people got sick in a food plant. But how are they going to get the food to you unless they were working? It's not like they wanted to get sick or something. It's not like they planned that.
No. But the other thing is that we're centralizing way too much food production. Farmers have lost the ability to decide where the meat is going to be slaughtered.
I heard that, right? It's being like sent to China or something. Why? That makes no sense to me.
So what we're going to have to do is we are going to have to talk to farmers in our local area and make a deal with them and maybe buy a whole cow and have it butchered and save it in a freezer. And that way we can have fresh meat and we can know where it came from and we can know that it's okay. It's not, you know, it's not a sick cow.
Mm-hmm. Well, I hope that you can do that. That may be something you can look into doing since.
Yeah, because I realize I can't run cattle. I do have a small hobby farm, but I can't be expected to do all the work of a cattle farmer. Not really.
No, definitely not. I mean, I totally get that for people that eat meat. I think they're going to have to look into these options. But even, like, I don't know, any other kind of food, it seems like there could be food shortages for pretty much anything at this point.
Yeah, no, they did that for potatoes, too. I don't have a green thumb, I'll tell you the truth. So I don't know. I had one potato sprout and I put it in a pot of soil, but I don't know what's going to happen with that because I'm terrible with those things.
I mean, I'm okay if I have sunlight, but I don't live somewhere that's conducive. And when I did, it was a lot of work. And then somebody made a comment that I was using water to water the plants. And I was like, oh, okay, did you not take a shower today? Okay.
Well, right now we're having too many showers outside. And did you hear what's going to happen with the weather this weekend in the northeast of the United States?
What's happening there?
There's going to be snow.
Oh, really? In May?
In May, yeah. This has not happened since 1978 or something like that.
Wow. Well, our weather is really unseasonably hot. It went from like in early April being rainy, like colder than usual, to like 100 degrees now, which is a little bit warmer than usual for early May.
Right. I don't know, but it doesn't seem to me that we are suffering from global warming in general.
No, we're just having weird weather patterns, but maybe this has always been the norm to some degree.
Yeah, of course. I mean, unusual weather is almost the rule. It's not the exception.
Yeah, you know, in previous centuries, people, they alter environments too. Like, it's not like modern man is treated the environment worse than previous centuries.
Yeah.
But some people say, which I find kind of alarming, it'd be better if there weren't people on the planet. The planet would be better off. That's kind of scary. Yeah.
And there are all these memes about how the dolphins are swimming in the canals, Venice, and all this other kind of stuff. And most of that is propaganda.
Yeah, I've never actually heard about that. I just hear people say things like that. But do we know? Like, we weren't there. And honestly, too, like, look, I love wildlife. I love animals. But right now, you're not even supposed to go to public parks anyway until this weekend when they open them up, maybe.
Well, I don't know. Up in the Northeast, it's going to snow. It's going to be like Christmas. It's going to be like a Christmas day.
Well, it's a weird weather pattern for sure.
Yeah. Well, speaking of which, I think I'm going to have to let you go because it looks like it might start raining and I have not gotten my ducklings and my chicks back into the tub.
Okay. Well, have a good evening. Okay.
Okay. You too, Julia. It was great talking to you.
Yeah. See you, and it was nice talk.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.